Zombies. Each day, the chance of a zombie invasion increases exponentially, and you need to be able to know how to protect yourself and which firearm to use. Let's get down to business. Now, I know when you're fighting actual zombies, you won't be able to have the time to put on the proper hearing and eye protection. But when you're training, you need to make sure that you have those on. Because if you're walking through the woods alone, you don't want a zombie sneaking up on you because you can't hear it or see it. So wear that protection and save your eyes and ears. There are three different types of guns that you can use when defending yourself against a zombie invasion. Shotguns, handguns, and rifles. Shotguns shoot a shotgun shell, which has a lot of BBs inside which spread out once it's fired. This allows you to cover a larger target. Pistols shoot a bullet, which is just a single projectile. The same with a rifle. Shotguns. There are a couple different firing mechanisms that you need to choose from when selecting the right shotgun for you. The first is a single or double break open. The second is a pump action. And the third is a semi-automatic. Now, these three different types of firing mechanisms have different firing rates. The single shot pump action, and the semi-automatic. Obviously, the semi-automatic can fire faster, so that will probably be your selection. Each shotgun shell can be filled with different size shot, or BBs. The smallest you can get is size 8. Much larger than that is size 3. Compared to each other, you can really see the difference in size. Some shotguns have interchangeable chokes. You put in the end of the barrel. Chokes control the distribution pattern of your shot once you fire it. There are 5 main types of chokes that your shotgun may come with. Full, which is the tightest grouping that you can have. Improved modified, modified, improved cylinder, and cylinder. Cylinder is essentially the end of the barrel without any choke, which will give you the largest spread pattern. This is the target shot with the full choke. As you can see, the shot density is pretty small. As we move to the improved modified choke, you can see that it starts to expand. And as we move through the remainder of the targets, you can see that the density continues to decrease, ending with the cylinder, which is pretty sparse. For moving targets, such as fast walking or running zombies, you'll want to lead the target. This means shooting in front of the target so that when your bullet or shot gets there, the target and the shot end at the same place. Similar to this, if this is the zombie and this is the bullet, and the zombie is moving, you want to shoot so it ends in the same place so you fully connect and kill your target. Rifles. Rifles also have different firing mechanisms. Muzzle loader, lever action, bolt action, and semi-automatic, like this one. These firing mechanisms also have different firing speeds. The first, bolt action, either from iron sights or a scope. Lever action, and semi-automatic. The semi-automatic obviously fires the fastest and would be the best choice. When selecting a rifle, you also need to consider the size of the bullet. You can get anything ranging from a small 22 shell to a large 30-06 shell. Pistols. Pistols also have different firing mechanisms. Nowadays, there's really only two main ones, semi-automatic and the revolver. These two really fire at pretty close to the same rate of speed. The only difference that you may encounter is magazine size. The revolver usually takes 6 or 8 shots, whereas the semi-automatic comes standard with maybe 6 to 7, but you can extend the magazine to hold upwards of 15 to 20. If you're lucky enough to be able to find some tracer rounds, you can also use those at night to shoot. This allows you to see where you're actually shooting and hit your target a lot more easily. Whatever gun you choose, make sure you're familiar with it and have it sighted in correctly so you can hit your target, one shot, one kill. No wasting ammunition. In the event that you're surprised by a zombie and you don't have a firearm, there are many other things that you can use to defend yourself, such as knives, machetes, or other tools you can find around the house, such as shovels, hammers, or a billhook. Go get 'em!